Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about design of plate girder. So first of all, let's discuss about what is plate girder. Plate girder is a built up section which is fabricated by using plates or angles so as to reduce the flexural loading. So this is the plate, this is one plate and this is the other plate, this is third plate. By using these three plates, we are manufacturing or we are fabricating the beam, or we can say a girder, that is called as a plate girder. So why these plate girders are provided? Even if we are having some rolled steel sections, so in your steel table the rolled steel sections are provided, but these are provided only up to a depth of 600 mm. But if the loading is high, in that situation the depth of the wave which is required will be more than 600. So in that situations we have to go for these plate girders. That means up to the required depth. Suppose we are requiring only 1000 mm depth of the wave, in that situation we have to use these plate girders. So first of all, let's discuss what are the different elements, or we can say components, of the plate girder. First one is wave, flanges, stiffeners. So this is your flange one, and this is top flange, and this is bottom flange. This is the wave. This top flange is provided to resist the bending, and this wave is provided to resist shear. And these two types of the stiffeners are provided. Why these stiffeners are provided, let us discuss. So this is the cross section of this beam, and this is the longitudinal section of this beam. So this is the top flange, this is the bottom flange, this is the vertical stiffener, this is also vertical stiffener, but this is end vertical stiffener, and these are intermediate. This is horizontal stiffener which is provided. So these waves are provided of required depth and thickness are provided to keep flanges at required distances and to resist the shear in the beam. So this is the wave, this is the wave. This wave is provided to keep these two flanges at particular distance and to resist shear in the beam. So the flanges are provided to resist bending moment developing the compressive force in one flange and tensile force in other flange. That means suppose these are the two flanges. In one flange compressive force will be generated, in other flange tensile force will be generated. By generating these compressive and tensile forces, these flanges are resisting bending in the beam. Now let us discuss about the stiffeners. The stiffeners are provided to safeguard the wave against local buckling failure. That means the stiffeners are provided to provide safety against local buckling, also to transfer the load from this top flange to the bottom flange. So basically there are two types of the stiffeners are provided: transfer stiffeners, which is called sometimes called as vertical stiffeners, and second one is a longitudinal stiffeners. These are called as a horizontal stiffeners. So these vertical stiffeners are of two types. First one is end bearing stiffeners and second one is intermediate stiffeners. So let us discuss one by one what is the function and why these stiffeners are provided. So this is vertical stiffener and this is your horizontal stiffeners. These vertical stiffeners are provided to transfer the load from these wave, that is transfer the shear force in the beam, and these horizontal stiffeners are provided to strengthen this wave against local buckling. That means these horizontal stiffeners are provided to provide a safety against local buckling, and these vertical stiffeners are provided to transfer the vertical shear along with the wave. So this is how they are used to strengthen the wave. First one against local buckling, that is horizontal stiffness, and second one to transfer the shear force. So this is all about various components in this plate girder. So all these components are to be designed. That means we have to determine the dimensions of these flanges, to determine the dimensions of the wave and bottom flange. Also we need to determine these vertical stiffness. Also we need to determine these horizontal stiffness. In vertical stiffness, end bearing stiffness and intermediate stiffness are designed differently. That means under various situations we need to provide only end bearing stiffness, under many situations we need to provide this intermediate stiffness only. So this is how we are designing each and every component. Apart from this each and every component, we are designing the connections between these components. So let us discuss about various types. So there are various types of the plate girder. So this is the first plate girder, in which this is your wave plate, and these wave plate are connected to these angles which are acting as a flange. These angles are acting as a flange, and as we are using the bolted connections, so these are called as bolted without cover plate. That means we are not providing any cover plate. So these are the plate girder with bolted connection but without cover plate. So this is the second type. In this plate girder, we are providing this wave plate and we are connecting these flanges, and this cover plate is provided to strengthen the plate girder. And this is the third type. We are using bolted connection. We are providing this side plate. So this is your side plate. This is the side plate. And apart from this side plate, we are using angles and cover plate. So this is called as a plate girder with bolted connection with side plate and cover plate. And this one is the fourth type, that is box girder, in which wave plate are provided and two flanges are provided, and these are connected by means of the welding. And the last one, this one is a welded plate girder. So this is the flange, this is top flange, this is bottom flange, and this is wave plate, and all these components are connected by means of using this welding. So this is in your syllabus, and we are going to discuss how to design this welded plate girder.